You know what I realized? If you ever see Tropic Thunder, I'm the dude playing the dude, disguised as another dude.
It's technically what's happening.
We are here today for day one of Hitman promo. We get to put on a lot of fun, different looks, and most importantly, we get to hang with the beautiful, funny, wonderful Audrey Arjona. So it's gonna be a good day.
It's a story about this guy, Gary Johnson, who worked undercover for the police department as a cop who sits across from you when you think you're trying to kill your wife or your husband and you think you're about to meet a hitman. You're actually about to meet a guy posing as a hitman who's about to arrest you. Everybody talked about how he was unrecognizable when he played these roles, but then when he went home, he was alone playing with his cat. He had a lot of birds. He was an ornithologist, and he just liked to read and be by himself. And then when he'd play all these different hitman roles, he became this like fascinating figure.
I actually wrote notes in my phone about all these before we started filming, so here they are.
Ron is Gary's alter ego.
Ron is an alpha, a wolf of sorts, a carnivore. There's just a sexiness to all the Ron stuff, you know, the way it's lit, the way it's covered, all that stuff. It's very different than the Gary stuff.
All right, Tanner's here. Ready to party. Tanner is the Southern alpha who's taking control of the situation. This should feel like the guy who loves to kill pigs with a knife.
Kind of nice, Hollywood, California.
I'll tell you, first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna see where they put those characters on Hollywood Boulevard. Go kiss Spider-Man on the mouth. He's not gonna do shit about it.
And you sketched all these tattoos off
for
yourself. Yeah.
Crazy green-eyed bear with lasers coming out of his eyes and American flags.
That's what I'm talking about.
Nico.
Each of these characters had to be like absolutely unique and defining, but at the end of the day, we had to kind of be able to use tools and techniques that Gary Johnson could actually hide behind. Homemade little tactics like putting cotton in your cheek to change the shape of your face, or putting things up your nose to make your nose wider. It's amazing what small little changes actually change the entire way you consume a face.
Got some Severus Snape vibes. Mr. Potter.
He's not actually Russian. You're Gary playing Russian. The crazy part about Russian is like where you put emphasis.
All bye is goodbye.
You don't need to know my name. Call me X.
X was a character that's straight out of American Psycho. I think it's just that general self-righteousness, that general sense of exactness, diction. High shine, high diction.
Savor everybody.
We talked about this character named Dean. He's got red hair, freckles, no eyebrows,
weird teeth,
and is sort of like what we consider just like a sociopathic serial killer nightmare. And that was the most fun one to play. The initial jumping off point was sort of like, okay, what's a cool version of like Javier Bardem in No Country?
Okay.
I know it's so scary, buddy. I know. He's like, get me off this thing's lap.
Honestly, when you have a great filmmaker as an actor, I can swing big on stuff like this because I know he's there to protect me. A lot of times Rick never saw these characters in the flesh before I stepped on a set.
So he walks out of the trailer. Nobody recognized him, including his assistant, who said, hey, does anybody know where Glenn is? And I said, it's Glenn.
To chew on all these different characters and feel you have to be a chameleon, that's one of the things. So there's a lot of pressure to play a character like that, but also like, yeah, an actor's dream.
There are three things you need to kill, man.
Yes.
The gun,
right?
The bullets,
mm-hmm.
And the balls, and boy, I'm stockpiling all three of those things. Oh.
Dive deeper into the Netflix shows and films you love on todoom.com.